Hello dear students, welcome back to my science class. Today I am going to teach you the fifth chapter of your NCERT science book, that is coal and petroleum. So let's start. We use various materials for our basic needs. Some of them are found in nature and some have been made by human efforts. Activity 5.1. Make a list of various materials used by us in daily life and classify them as natural and man-made. So, the various material we use, you can classify them in two types, natural and man-made. Does this list include air, water, soil and minerals? I'm sure that all of your natural resources including these things, air, water, soil and mineral, because these are so essential that without these things we cannot survive. So all of your natural resources must include air, water, soil and minerals. But I know your man-made resources can vary. Your list containing something like plastic, like synthetic fibers, like different alloys, and someone list containing some other things. But air, water, soil and minerals are essential natural resources. Without that, we cannot survive. Since all this obtained from nature, these are called natural resources. Can we use? Now the question comes in Bozo's mind that can we use all natural resources forever? Can air, water and soil be exhausted by human activities? You have already studied about water in class 7. Is water a limitless resource? In the light of availability of various resources in nature, natural resources can be broadly classified into two types. Number one is inexhaustible natural resources. What are those? These resources are present in unlimited quantity in nature and are not likely to be exhausted by human activities. Examples are sunlight, air, even water also included can be included in inexhaustible natural resources because amount of water present in this earth is limitless. But we have to think about drinking water. Potable water is really limited in this earth. So we have to be very careful while using these resources. So first category of resources is inexhaustible natural resources, that is also known as renewable natural resources that cannot be exhausted by human activity. Second group of resources, exhaustible natural resources. The amount of these resources in nature is limited. They can be exhausted by human activities. Example of these resources are forests, wildlife, minerals, coal, petroleum, natural gas, etc. If we do not be wise enough to use this natural resources, this can come to an end one day. So these are known as exhaustible natural resources. Activity 5.2. It is a group activity. Take some container, fill them with popcorn, peanut, roasted gram, toffees. Means you have taken some edible thing. Divide student into group of 7 each. That means in your class, if 35 students are there, you have divided them into 5 groups. Further divide each group into 3 subgroups containing 1, 2 and 4 students. Label them as 1st, 2nd and 3rd generation respectively. As population is increasing day by day, so 1st generation containing 1 student, 2nd generation containing 2 students and 3rd generation containing 4 students are quite reasonable. These subgroups represent the consumers. As population is growing, second and third generation have large number of consumers. Put one full container for each group on a table. Ask consumer to consume eatable from the container of their group. Now ask the second generation consumer from each group to do the same. Ask student to observe carefully the availability of the eatables. We will see gradually the number of eatables become lesser. We have to watch that if the third generation consumers are getting any eatable at all or not, or if the number of eatable become finished before third generation consumer can use it. Assume that eatable in the containers represent the total availability of an exhaustible natural resource like coal, petroleum or natural gas. Each group may have a different consumption pattern. Are the earlier generation of any group too greedy? It may be that the earlier generation in some groups were concerned about the coming generation and left something for them. So it is depending upon the population. If they are too greedy to use all the exhaustible natural resources in their time, then future generation will be in a great trouble. They will not get any exhaustible natural resources, those who are extremely important for their survival, to use in the future. In this chapter, we will learn about some exhaustible natural resources like coal, petroleum, natural gas. How they form and what are their uses, we will learn in this chapter. These are formed from dead remain of living organisms, that is fossils. So, these are known as fossil fuels. So, in this chapter, we are going to know about the fossil fuels, how they are produced, what are their uses, and how we have to use them. Coal. You may have seen coal or heard about it. It is as hard as stone and is black in color. Coal is one of the fuel used to cook food earlier. It was used in railway engines to produce steam to run engine. It is also used in thermal power plants to produce electricity. Coal is used as a fuel in various industries. So you can understand that without coal, industries cannot run. Without coal, power generation cannot possible. So this is extremely important exhaustible natural resource. Story of coal. How, where do we get coal and how it is formed? So that is the story of coal. About 300 million years ago, Earth had dense forest in low-lying wetland areas. Due to natural processes like flooding, this forest got buried under the soil. As more soil deposited over them, they were compressed. They got pressure and they compressed under pressure. The temperature also rose as they sank deeper and deeper. Under high pressure and high temperature, dead plants got slowly converted to coal. As coal contains mainly carbon, the slow process of conversion of dead vegetation into coal is called carbonization. Since it was formed from the remain of vegetation, coal is also called a fossil fuel. So, coal is mainly formed from dead plants. Dead plants that were present in low-lying land and soil is deposited over them. So, for so many years, due to high pressure and temperature, they got converted into coal. As coal contains mainly carbon, so this slow process of conversion of dead vegetation into coal is carbonization. And definitely it is formed from vegetation, so also it is known as fossil fuel. Just you can see. When heated in air, coal burns and produces mainly carbon dioxide. Just now we have discussed that main component of coal is carbon. Heated in air means definitely it will react with oxygen and will produce carbon dioxide. Coal is processed in industry to get some useful products such as coke, coal tar and coal gas. What are the uses? Coke. It is a tough, porous and black substance. It is an almost pure form of carbon. It is used in manufacturing of steel and extraction of many metal. So it is very, very important, almost pure form of carbon. Second is the coal tar. It is a black and thick liquid with an unpleasant smell. It is a mixture of about 200 substances. Products obtained from coal tar are used as starting material for manufacturing various substances used in everyday life and in industry, like synthetic dyes, drugs, explosives, perfumes, plastic, paints, photographic materials, roofing materials, etc. Interestingly, naphthalene balls used to repel moths and other insects are also obtained from coal tar. Just to think about the smell of the naphthalene ball. So, what a varied use we can get of coal tar. These days, bitumen, a petroleum product, is used in place of coal tar for melting the roads. Next is coal gas. Coal gas is obtained during the processing of coal to get coke. It is used as a fuel in many industries situated near the coal processing plant. Coal gas used for street lighting for the first time in London in 1810 and New York around 1820. Nowadays, it is used as a source of heat rather than light. So, this is all about one inexhaustible natural resource, that is coal. We have learned how coal is formed. We have learned about various uses of coal. In the next class, we will learn about petroleum and natural gas. Thank you.